Corporate Finance OneNote Practice Problem. In this presentation, we're going to work a practice problem in OneNote related to the cost of not taking cash discount, this time working an example problem. We saw the calculations of the cost of not taking a cash discount in a prior presentation. This time, the example problem will make it a bit more concrete, a bit more clear. Get ready. It's time to take your chance with corporate finance. Here we are in OneNote. If you would like to follow along in OneNote, you're not required to do so, but if you have access to it and would like to, we are in the 812, a cost of not taking cash discount example tab in the practice problems section. Closing this back out, we got our information up top. We're going to put that into the blue area on the right and on the bottom as we work through the practice problem. This will be similar to the prior practice problem we had where we did work through the cost of not taking the cash discount, but then we didn't really apply it to an actual dollar amount as if we were to purchase something on account and consider the comparison of the financing as we will do this time. So we'll do the calculation and then we'll consider what would happen if we actually financed this comparing an actual dollar amount if we were to basically take out a loan amount and calculate the amount as opposed to taking the calculation for the cost of not taking the discount. And this will make that calculation a bit more concrete. So what we have here is we can borrow for 22%. So we're imagining we can borrow money for 22%. We have to use the borrowed cash to take the cash discount. So we're purchasing on account. We're purchasing on account. The vendor that we're purchasing from is giving us terms. Those terms are 2/10 net 65. So what does that mean? Once again, that means that if we pay within the 10-day time period, we get a 2% discount. Or in other words, 2% discount if you pay within 10 days. Otherwise, you pay within 65 days, or you might have some, we might take collection action at that point or have some other penalties that could happen after that point in time. So with our cash management strategy then, we're going to say, okay, if I take the discount, I'm going to wait till the end of 10 days because I'm going to hold on to the cash as long as I can and pay the latest point that I can in order to maximize the purchase price that I will have taking the 2% discount. If I don't pay or I don't take the 2% discount, I'm going to pay at the end of 65 days. I'm going to wait till the very end of the time period to maximize my cash management strategy. Now, if we have the cash, if we've got sufficient cash flow and cash flow isn't a problem, normally, it would be beneficial to take the discount. That's the point of the discount in and of itself. So normally, if we had the cash flow and we're just like, well, either I pay at the end of 10 days or 65, it would break our normal pattern of paying at the end of 65 days because we only do that for our normal cash management strategy to maximize our cash flow as much as possible. And if we had the cash flow and they basically gave us a 2% discount, then we would probably just break our normal strategy and then pay at the end of the discount time period to take advantage of the 2% discount, which would probably be more beneficial for us to hold on the cash. But if we're financing then, if we're financing the purchase of, say, inventory, then it's a little bit more complex because we're going to have to take out a loan to finance the purchase. So remember, if we're taking out a loan, then the question is, well, I have this time period, the 65 days minus the 10 days, that time period in which I would have the loan. I wouldn't have had the loan if I just waited till the end of 65 days. So is the benefit of me taking out or financing the payment, you know, at the earlier point after 10 days beneficial, or would it be more beneficial for us to wait till the end of 65 days if we're going to be financing this and just pay the full amount and not take that little discount since I'm financing anyways? So that's going to be what this calculation does. The calculation is the cost of not taking the cash discount. Then we're going to test this by actually assuming that we purchase something for $100,000. So if we purchase something for $100,000, then the discount, if we were to pay within 10 days, we'd get a 2% discount. So the discount would be then obviously the $2,000. So I'll just do the calculation just for the fun of it. We got the $100,000 times 0.02 is going to be the $2,000. And then obviously the principal less the discount would be the $98,000. So in other words, if I was to finance this, we'd have to take a loan. I'm sorry, it'd be the $100,000 minus the $2,000, $98,000. If we were to finance this, we could take the loan out at the end of 10 days and only need then the $98,000 at that point in time, rather than the $100,000, which was the purchase price that we'd have to pay at the end of 65 days. Okay, so let's first do the cost of not taking the discount calculation, which is this item. That'll give us a percent. And if that percent, this is the cost of not taking the discount in a percentage form. If that percent is higher than the interest rate on the loan, which in our case is 22%, then we would want to take the loan out and finance it. If this comes out lower, then we would say, okay, I'll just wait and then pay at the end of the time period. So let's do that first. We're going to say that the discount is going to be 2%. I'm going to do this in a table format. I'm going to do this first half first. Discount divided by 100% minus the discount. So 2% is the discount. 100% minus 2% is 98%. Subtotal then is going to be the 0.02 divided by the 0.98, or the 2.04816, and so on. Then I'll do the second half, which is 360 days minus the period we're covering, the final date minus the discount date. So then we're going to say the second half is the days in a year. We're going to assume not 365, but 12 times 30, a nice even 30-day months, or 360. And then we got the final due date minus the discount. Because remember, if we're not taking the discount, we're going to wait till the end of 65 days. But if we take the discount, we're going to pay at the end very endpoint we can to take the discount, which is 10. That's our cash management strategy. Therefore, we're going to say the difference that we would have to finance is the 55 days if we were to take a loan out to pay early, and that would be 55 days. This is the inverse of basically the time component of like the interest calculation. So, and we'll talk more about that, you know, later. Okay, so then we got the 360 divided by 55, 360 over 55. That's going to give us about the 6.5454 and so on. And then if I take that number and multiply it times the 0.02048, we get about, moving the decimal over, 13.36 about here. So that's going to be our 13.36 cost of not taking the discount. Now the discount that we have is 2022 at this point. So this is going, the cost of us not taking the discount is less. So we would want to then not take the discount instead of financing it at 22 at this point. And so in this case, we would just simply not take the discount. Let's kind of prove that to us. Let's take a look at it and see if we can justify that by using actual numbers and then calculate the rate of interest that would be covered. So let's do our interest calculation. Just basically going to be I times equals interest is the loan or principal times the rate times the time. This time is our fraction of a year, which notice this calculation has kind of like the inverse of the fraction of the year. So just, you know, okay, so we got the loan. We got the loan amount is $98,000 of the loan, because once again, if we pay it within the discount period, we get the discount. So we only have to be taking the loan out for 98 is all we need, rather than the 100. The rate, we're going to assume we could take a loan at 22%. So 98,000 times 22% is going to be 21,560. That would be the interest for the entire year. And then now I can calculate this a couple different ways. Here's the interest for the entire year. And I can multiply that times the percent of a year. Because remember, this interest rate, the 22%, is for a year. Whenever we hear an interest rate, it's basically a year. So this would be the interest if we had it for an entire year. Then we have to multiply times T, which is basically a ratio. And the ratio in our case is going to be 20. How many days did we have? 55 days over 360. It would be 55 over 360 would be our ratio times the 21,560 we'd have here. Now, the other way we can calculate that and say, okay, if that's the interest for a year, let's break that out into an interest per day. And this is, I think this is, you know, makes sense to a lot of people. So 21,560 interest per year divided by 360 would mean you'd have $59.89 per day. And then we're going to say that there's 55 days that are being covered here. So if we're thinking about interest of 59.89 per day times 55, we've got $3,293.89. So there's the $3,293.89 once again. Now that $3,293.89 is an interest that we'd have to charge if we were taking the loan is greater than the $2,000 discount that we would have in order to pay early. So in that case, you can see that it wouldn't make sense for us to do that, to take out a loan of the $98,000 just to pick up the savings of the $2,000, considering the loan's going to cost us $3,293. Now, just to prove this break even, let's look at the break even point because we calculated up top the 13.36. If I plug that into my interest calculation, it should break even, right? Because that's the break even point. That's the cost of not taking the discount. So that at that point, we should find a discount of 2,000. So let's do that. Same calculation. We're going to do the same calculation as if we can take a loan out for that break even point, the cost of not taking the discount percent. So let's say we have the 98,000 loan. The rate, now we're going to use that 13.36 about, it's rounded, 13.36 about will give us then the interest if we were for an entire year. This would be the interest on a year, right? And then I'm going to divide that by 360 to see the interest per day. This is the fraction of a year calculation, the time calculation. And then if that's per day, I'm going to multiply that times the number of days or 55 to give us the interest for that time period, the 55 days, which would be 2,000, which of course is the amount of the discount that we would get. We'd get that $2,000 discount. That's why this is the cost of not taking the discount. That's the cost of not taking the discount. That's kind of our break-even percent in terms of the loan percent. If we get a percent better than that, then we want to take it. We want to take the discount and take the loan. If we get a percent worse than that in terms of the loan, then we're just going to say, no, thank you. I'll pay the extra 2,000, paying the whole 100,000 at the end of the term. Let's do it again. And we'll see it one more time, a little bit different scenario. So now we're going to say we can borrow at 22% still, but now the terms are 3.5% discount if you pay within 15 days, otherwise you pay within 60 days. So we'll do this again. We're going to say, all right, that means you get a 3.5% discount if we pay within 15, otherwise we pay within 60 days. If we then do our example, which we'll do afterwards, after we do the cost of not taking the cash discount calculation, we're going to say that we purchased something for 100,000. If we take the discount at 3.5%, that means that we would have to pay less. We get a discount of 3,500. In other words, we would be paying over only 96,500 if we pay within 15 days. Otherwise, if we pay at the end of 60 days, we will pay 100,000. So the cost of not taking the discount, we're going to do the first half of the calculation. The discount percent is going to be 3.5. The 100% minus the discount, 96.5. If we divide those two out using the trusty calculator here, we're going to have the 0.035 divided by the 0.0965 is going to be the let's do that one more time. The 0.035 divided by the 0.965 is going to be the, moving the decimal over, 3.626269 about. All right. Okay. And then the second half of our calculation is the days in a year, or 360, assuming nice even days, 12 times 30, nice even months, 30 day months. And then the final due date minus the discount, that's the time period we're covering, because we're assuming if we do not take the discount, we're going to wait until 60 days to pay as late as possible with regards to our cash management strategy. If we do take the discount, we're going to pay as late as possible to take the discount, or at day 15. So then the difference between those two is 45. That's the time period that we're talking about with regards to our decision-making process. So then we're going to take the 360 divided by 45, and that gives us 8. And then we're going to take then the 0.036269 times 8, and that's going to give us, if we move the decimal over, 29.02 about. So now let's kind of prove that. That means basically that's the cost of not taking the discount. If we have to finance this thing in order to save that $3,500, if we have to do so at a rate that is below the 29, then we'll do it because the interest of the cost of the loan will be lower. If the interest rate is higher than that, we will not do it because the cost of the loan, the interest will cost more than the cost of taking the discount. So let's prove that or think about it with our scenario where we are purchasing something for 100,000. Therefore, if we pay it within the discount time period, we're going to get a 3.5% discount or 3,500, meaning we will only pay 96,500 at that point. So let's say we took out the loan with our calculation here. Interest equals the loan times the rate times the time. Time is a fraction of a year, so that's a little bit confusing. Rate means the rate for an entire year. That's what rate means. We don't really usually give the rate per month or per day. We have the yearly rate. So we're going to say, all right, the loan principal is now going to be the $96,500. If we were to take out a loan to finance this purchase, the rate we're going to say is that 22% once again that we can take a loan for. And the $96,500 times 22% would be $21,230. Then I'm going to do the time instead of multiplying times the fraction of the year, which would be in our case, the 45 divided by 60, the fraction of the year. I'm going to do the same thing, but we're just going to say if that's the interest, if it were outstanding for an entire year, because this rate means for an entire year, if I divide that by the number of days in a year, about 360, 12 times 30, making all the months even, that would mean that per day we would have about $58.97 per day. And then if I multiply that times the number of days, 45 days that are in our loan period, that would give us about $2,653. So notice this is just a fraction. We could do the same thing as saying 45 divided by 360 times the 21,230. That would be our time interval for this calculation. All right, so that's going to be the 2635 or 2653. That is less than the discount here, which kind of proves the fact that we would be beneficial. It would be beneficial for us to finance this, take out the loan for the $96,500, pay the interest of the 2653 on it in order to save the $3,500 discount that we get on the purchase. Let's prove this again by saying, okay, what if I use this rate, which is basically the break-even rate, as if I can get a loan just for that rate, and just prove that it's kind of like the break-even point. If I was to get a loan for 29.02, I'd say, okay, let's do the same calculation. We're going to say we got the $96,500. That's how much we would have to, that's the loan amount that we'd have to pay if we pay within this discount time period, times the rate of 29.02. That's the cost of not taking the discount rate. We're assuming we can take a loan for that. That would be interest if it were for an entire year of $28,000. Then we're going to multiply the time principal. I'm going to do it this way, dividing it by 360, the days in a year, which gives us the cost per day, $77.78 about. And then the number of days that we have to cover are 48 days. Therefore, that would give us $3,500. The interest would cost us $3,500, that being equal to what we would save by paying within the discounted time period. That's why it's kind of our break-even point. That's why it's the cost of not taking the discount.